Okay, so hello. My name is Jodie.
I'm Scarlett, guest host for today.
And this is the first in a series of videos that I'm going to make on being vegan and trying to make the transition to veganism much simpler and easier. We're going to be making delicious, cheap, and easy food to make this all easier for you. And today we're going to be making roasted mushroom burgers with caramelized onion relish, with corn on the cob and butter, beetroot and celeriac slaw, and polenta crusted wedges.
It's gonna be good.
So let's get cracking with the cooking.
It's great being really tall because then you can just forget people like this. And then now I'm the star of the show. Not really.
This is not the safest way to cook. Please don't kill me.
Sorry, that's not safe either. If you're a child watching this,
don't do what I'm doing. I'm more experienced than you.
In so many ways.
Okay, so I don't know if anybody knows about these knives.
Kun
It's backwards
Rikon.
right now, but it says Kun Rikon. These are the most amazing knives ever, and they're actually affordable. They're actually sexual. They're so good. So anyway. Back to the cooking. Basically, cut in half again, cut in half again. Wedges. Throw them in a pan. It's pretty straightforward.
Jodie has chopped all of the potatoes up and now they look like this, beautiful wedges. Not too big, but they're also quite substantial, so they're not
you probably
like
only
poxy
need,
little chips.
Yeah, like four or five.
Yeah.
Reasonable
so
sized potatoes.
These potatoes that we've got in here are going to be three adults and one hungry child for the evening. So that's plenty for a family of four. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Okay, so now we're going to make the polenta crust for the potatoes. So we have ourselves a nice bowl here. And Jodie, go ahead. We're going to get some oil now. Now this oil, I personally think, is beautiful. It's a healthier oil. It's got an amazing orange colour. It's a bit more expensive probably than crappier oil, really, but it's better for you. It doesn't clog up your arteries and
be generous with it.
Yeah, be generous with it. You want them to be nice and crispy.
Just remember, as a vegan, you have to give up so many things. Do not give up oil.
Rub it all over your body as much as you can. This is polenta crust and flour and stuff.
It's
okay.
It's gritty.
Grit. The Americans call it grit. It's also what I've got on the base of Domino's pizza, just so I don't know.
Just to let you know. I've just mixed in probably about 3 tablespoons of the polenta stuff.
To about 2.5 tablespoons of oil.
Maybe 3, I'm quite generous. It soaks up anything you put with it, so you'll probably need to use a little bit more oil. Like I said, I'm very liberal with the oil. So,
I've got some salt in. We've got to season because flavours are massively important. They should be important in all types of cooking, but I think especially so in vegan cooking because you can really bring out the flavour of so many different vegetables and grains and everything, especially tofu. You need spice, you need herbs, you need these sort of things. So be liberal, season well, and do your job as a citizen.
So,
back with the wedges now, and I think my lovely host, Jodie the Den.
More.
So Jodie Moore, she's married now. Sorry guys, she's got a ring on it. She's not free. She's spoken for. Anyway, we'll stop talking about her. So now she's just basically massacring the potatoes because the bowl obviously isn't quite big enough for the job that she wanted it to do. I would say get your hands in. I don't know how she feels about doing that. She's gonna go for it. She's gonna take her rings off.
Taking the rings off.
And she's gonna go for it, ladies and gentlemen. Now, obviously, keep your rings on if you want. I don't care. You're gonna eat it. But it's a bit gross.
This is actually way more effective, so yeah.
Exactly. And you're not gonna chuck it everywhere. Spoons are great. Stirring, not great for coating things with the ingredients that you need to make them so delicious.
Yeah, they go back in the pan. And I'm gonna need to wash my hands.
Hello, we're back and we've swapped. So now, Jodie, what are we doing?
We are now going to marinate the mushrooms. Ideally, you'd use portobello mushrooms, but in this case, and for cheapness again, because, you know, substituting things means that everything's more affordable, these are just flat ones.
Yeah, large flat mushrooms.
Yeah. So we're marinating the mushrooms in olive oil, garlic and chili flakes. At the moment, Scarlett is just cutting about a clove's worth of garlic, I think, and she's going to put it in this wonderful contraption, which is a garlic press, and then it's going to go in the bowl for the marinade.
If you don't have a garlic press, you can just mash it up with the back of a knife and some salt, and it kind of just has the same effect, really, but it's a little bit more time consuming. But all of us have these wonderful gadgets. Sorry if I squeeze garlic in your face, Judy.
I like garlic.
Scrape it off with the back of the knife. Get it all in. Just got some olive oil. This is actual olive oil. This is different to the oil we were using for the...
You can use the other stuff, but I prefer this.
That much?
Yeah, that looks good. So, what do you reckon, about 3-4 tablespoons?
I reckon about 3 tablespoons in there, yeah. Okay, and we're just gonna add... Ooh, sorry everybody, that was a bit loud. Ooh. My bionic knee exploded. About a teaspoon of this wonderful, very lazy, chopped red chilli.
This stuff is a lifesaver. It stops also, you from having, like, packets of fresh chillies going all mouldy and rank.
And it also... Save your fingers, because I put them in my eye after chopping up chilies.
Me too.
And that's not very nice. Obviously with chili, it's all very personal. Put in as much or as little as you like. Just really...
Yeah, slop it in.
Rub it in. Rub it in. Like that.
You want to leave as much of the coating on as possible, really.
Okay. Okay, so we have a nice coated oily mushroom. Just going to move that over to put it on a baking tray, ready to go into the oven. These don't need to go in quite yet because obviously the potatoes will take quite a bit longer. Not going in the oven just yet, but we didn't put quite enough oil in the pot, so we're just going to do a little drizzling over, just like that, just to make sure they don't get all dried out. And that's your mushroom burgers prepared!
Okay, so this is the beetroot and celeriac coleslaw, or slaw. So this is a celeriac. If anyone hasn't seen one of these before...
They're ugly.
Yeah, they're fucking ugly. So, Scarlett made the comparison to Lemmy from Motorhead's face earlier, which I thought was quite apt.
But we love you, Lemmy.
Rock and roll. So, that... We need a couple of carrots. See? And some beetroot.
How do we attack this?
Well, this is the thing, you need a really bloody good knife. Like so! See?
Okay, let's go.
Okay, so we use probably about a quarter of the celeriac. You don't need too much of it. If you don't know what to do with the rest of your celeriac, it makes a really good mash. So do like a half and half of potatoes and celeriac, and maybe add a couple of teaspoons of whole grain mustard. Mwah. Lovely.
Delicious.
So next we're going to do the carrots. So you want to peel your carrots. You don't want any gangly bits in there. I said bits.
You'll learn very quickly. We're children.
Just big children.
Just big children.
Overgrown children.
But we are safe to use around knives. We are safe to use around knives. We are safe around knives.
That's not funny.
That's not funny. Knife crime is a problem. It is. But don't be going out stabbing people with your Kung Recon knife, because you're going to blunt it when you want to cut it, use it for vegetables, and it's just not worth it.
You don't want that.
Right. So we're going to shred the carrots.
I chopped off the top and the bottom, by the way, so again, you've got no dangly bits.
Okay,
left.
Get ready. Bring it loud.
That may be enough.
I think we may only need to use one carrot rather than two.
Let's have a little look.
Eat your other carrot. Carrots are great. Help you see in the dark.
Stop throwing things in the house.
Sorry, I do apologise, everybody. I'm a thug.
Yes, as you can see, that is actually probably enough now. So, use one carrot. We're just making it up as we go along then. The celeriac is the base. Next, we have beetroots. Now, might want to cut them up. Are they okay?
They'll be fine.
Alright, shove them in.
And there is a ball. It's a bowl. It's too big for the coleslaw that sits within it.
A ball.
A ball! The ball is too small! Right, you're going to make the dressing.
Okay, so the wedges have probably been in for about 20, 25 minutes now.
Okay, yeah.
So I'm going to get them out and check them. Oh, and then you get steamy glasses, which is a really clever idea. Okay, so wedges are looking nice and crusty.
As you can see, no, you can't see. It's crunchy.
Crunchy.
Go.
Crunchy. And so, I reckon it's probably time to put the mushrooms in now.
How long would you say the mushrooms take to cook, Jodie?
I wouldn't do any more than about 25 minutes. What happens with the mushrooms is that they kind of release all their juices when they go in the oven, and you want to kind of keep it, you know, not completely dried out. So you want to keep the juices, basically. So we've put the wedges on the top shelf because they take longer, and we're going to put these in the middle shelf.
Right. What's next, Judy?
Okay, I personally don't use this one very much, but this is all I could get. I usually use the Tiger brand.
This is mayonnaise, by the way.
Yep, egg-free mayonnaise. This is alright, it's not too bad. I'm probably going to do a review at some point of all the different mayonnaises, so you can figure out which one's good for you. So you need copious amounts of this stuff.
Watch the squirts, guys.
Pop it in there.
Lastly,
with the coleslaw, you want to put your chives in. Most coleslaws have some sort of onion in them. Personally, I find it quite hard to get the ratio right. You have to put less rather than more in. But if you put chives in, it's a lot subtler.
And it smells amazing.
Now, I find the best way to cut stuff like this
is... crazy.
No, don't go crazy.
Oh, don't go crazy.
Go mildly crazy.
Go mildly crazy.
Bunch it up together, like so, okay? And then you want to go like so. It's so fun. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Like today, it's not working.
Keep going. It's going to work. So there we go.
There's the mildly crazy
bit. You're really rich and fabulous, you may have them as a lunar chopper, which for you, that's fantastic. But for normal paupers like us...
Some of those.
Yeah, that's a rocky
chopper. Things.
A mezzaluna. Little tip for you there. Little tip for everybody. Yeah, spread pantry. Hey, so this is bread Jenga.
Shit. So, here is our plate. As you can see, we've got the polenta crusted shit and the beetroot and celeriac slaw with the lovely Vitalite covered corn on the cob and our mushroom burger. Yum yum! Well,
thanks for watching, everyone!
Thanks for watching! Bye!
Bye.
Who's gonna show you tasty food when the rest of the world don't want to? Vegasmic, Vegasmic. When you're done with hugging trees and you need a giant vegan feast, Vegasmic, Vegasmic. See you signing up for good free food and a go anywhere else would just be rude. Vegasmic, Vegasmic. Who's gonna show you tasty food?